Chopin seems to be clear that there are certain threads being threatening, the general threatening, the one general move as we expected, and we think we are right to expect it this way, and implicitly some problems and major challenges we face today globally have been mentioned as well. Saying we face them globally, there's always something where we can say as well, problems with Chinese, German, French, English, Irish, simple Johannesburgian problems. I will try to mention some of them. I'm well aware of the fact that this is not an exhaustive list or exhaustive picture. There are, in my opinion, especially when we look at the current topic of post-colonialism, nationalism and internationalism and supranationalism, especially three main areas where the current country still valid system of nation states, the related citizenship, and national interests are systematically undermined. These are first digitization and artificial intelligence. Then we have second, the area of demographic development. Looking here in particular at the international and global level, people moving from different areas to other areas, center periphery. In this way, it is fair to say that what we see is actually what they wanted to see. Symbolically, they wanted to, many of them wanted to. First, let us look at digitization and artificial intelligence. First, let us look at the issue of digitization and artificial intelligence. I do this a little bit more extensive, especially as it is, in my view, a major point of development, questioning most of the characteristics that we usually combine or see in connection with the modern state, saying that the modern state is actually the modern welfare state with or based on the rule of law. I said already that the rule of law is becoming problematic as the states are actually becoming problematic and are kind of withering away, being taken over by private enterprises and corporations. I'll come back to this later. First, digitization, artificial intelligence. Part of this had been an early stage of digitalization, namely the effort to formulate everything in a way that makes it calculable. We can say mathematization, numerification, much later digitization. These are expressions of such trends, but equally the fundamental humanist ideas or ideologies presume that the rational being goes into the world representing two different approaches, completely different approaches to measuring the world. Daniel Kehlmann had been elaborating this, finding still a common expression in Kant's categorical imperative, a highly individualist concept of rationality. Here we find the onset of the contractualist approach to understand society and their members, the citizens. The result is thinking, the result is understanding human relationships resting on the binary code of jurisprudence. Although such thinking is most pronounced in trade and other commercial relations, it is the general zeitgeist of modernity. Like purchasing contracts, we find social contracts and constitutions alike designed on the principle of two parties relating to each other according to ex ante defined criteria. A third party, if involved, being so as a mediator, the judge in law, possibly the solicitor. Anyway, today, however, this pattern changed in a far-reaching way, and binarization, numerification, are at least in some areas replaced, or it is visible, it is foreseeable that this will happen in the very near future, that the setting is gone beyond the binary code, and that now the gamer, let's take it from the game, from the gaming world, the gamer who can influence the development in a completely unexpected way. This is extended by adding actors so that the machine is only one actor amongst others and limited as the others as well. In other words, the enforcing dominance replacement can be imagined for the very near future. The individualizing characters come as soon as and to the extent to which the technology is used for areas that have been gain their own citizenry. I alluded to gaming where we can see this. These are not predefined games, even the rules are not completely predefined, but they change throughout the game. This is very important when we transpose this on the political level and look at what is now called international relations, where we have the nation states, the citizenry, and the economy as part of the nation states, relating to other nation states with the same setting, the state as a political instance, the economic market, society of the citizens as the political force of the entire polity. Now, as I said, this changes because there are different, well, this changes, but there are different ways how it can change. The one more or less a prolongation of what we have today is simply still a fundamental change, a prolongation, still a fundamental change, insofar that the states are actually more and more increasingly an entrepreneur. There is the saying of the entrepreneurial state. And if we take this as a metaphor, it is actually the state not necessarily owning businesses, running businesses, but setting the terms and conditions and behaving itself as a state according to the criteria of efficiency and this kind of success, monetary success. This is not done so by individuals, although they enter in a way the same legal setting of being asked to define in advance what is going to happen. As I said, this changes. On the one hand, we find the state now as economic actors, the foundations or corporations becoming major polities, if we want. Bill Gates, for instance, having this strange job or vocation of being a philanthropist. And as such, it is not just doing good, if it is that, but it is as well deciding what is good. We have there, considering Bill Gates as a kind of self-pronounced Minister for Education and Health, we have there this picture, the expectation. What is actually happening there is a replacement of political bodies by the corporations. Now, you still have a third pillar. This is really the citizenry. These are the people who are possibly enjoying going for a hike there, who are enjoying their stands. In a way, you can say all is fine, and they act all according to their own rules, and they know themselves. It had been shown earlier in a work together with Weird Babakan that the understanding of citizenship is actually, to some extent at least, dissolving, and that we find a move to a new definition of citizenship that is not concerned or not linked to the nation state, but that it is linked to certain groups that are defined by different criteria. There is a professional status, professional orientation, orientation on grounds of religion, and so on and so forth. There is a wide debate in law as well on these issues, especially about coming from the systems theory. What to do with it is, what to do with these developments is, of course, still an open question. But in this respect, the Southeast Asian countries, and in particular China, are in a new position, in a very favorable condition to shape the future in this understanding. Because on the one hand, we find the powerful and large country and economy of China, but at the same time, it does not continue with the old structures, and it is by its very nature, as well defined by both, by being a single economy, a closed market system, if we want to use this term of the market still, and it is an open economy, being completely depending and creating dependencies in the context of value chains, of poverty chains, of new forms as well of support. Of course, as said, it is about decolonialization, overcoming the old dependencies, while it is not clear where it goes into the future, because internationalism, nationalism are concepts that are under threat, that cannot be simply taken and imported. Yering had been discussing this as well, that you cannot implant a law, a legislative system from another country if it is not something that is deeply felt in the character, in the tradition of the country. So what we have actually in China in particular, it is a completely different understanding of what society is. It is not the individual being responsible towards the society, but it is the society actually taking care of the individual, and with this turning the relationship of the old Western understanding of society around and establishing a new understanding of what it is. Now, if the borders are not the borders of the national system anymore, we find actually already projects like the OBOR or something similar, where the emphasis is on international cooperation. Xi Jinping said in 2014 in a conference to the to the UNESCO something of the interest, the basic interest of China, which is not the interest of expansion, but it is the interest of, and then we go back to old concepts, actually, Confucian tradition, as well Buddhism, of harmony, of engagement, not with the nature, but understanding oneself as part of nature. So it is, as it should be, of course, this merger of traditional thinking with something that is happening in the future, where we have this complex field of different possibilities, where we do not know exactly where it goes, where actually society building, and this would be my conclusion, is happening as something pointing in a very open future, but where openness does not mean that we do not play a role anymore, that we cannot change it anyway, but that where we have the opportunity and the obligation to find ways, to find criteria as well, be it in political, in terms of political science, be it in terms of legal science, be it as well, not least in terms of culture, to define this future, where I would say it has to go beyond international regimes, and where it has to go actually towards an understanding of the future society as world society, as a global issue that is overcoming nation states, is overcoming colonialism, as well overcoming colonial post-colonial status, but where we still do not know what the future shapes will be, where part of these future shapes will be, of course, a massive redistribution, but not a redistribution simply and solely and primarily in terms of the results of the products, but in terms of the process of production itself. So yes, it's stupid. It's all about the economy.